Hi, I'm Drew Dwyer, Airlines Industrial Product Manager for Eaton Automation Solutions. If you're looking for a simple solution for motor starter applications with multi-speed capabilities without the use of a full-blown variable frequency drive, you should take a look at the Eaton DE1 Variable Speed Starter. The DE1 is ideal for customers who require variable motor speed, but where a full VFD would be too complex or too expensive for their application. I've seen it used in many different ways, but most frequently on equipment such as air handlers, conveyors, chillers, mixers, and fillers. By installing the Eaton DE1, you can achieve the energy efficiency you need with the simplicity of a conventional motor starter. You'll get the added benefits of easy installation, easy commissioning, a compact footprint, and a smaller price point. The Eaton DE1 is available in two frame sizes for motors up to 10 horsepower. Its plug-and-play, keypad-free design means no specialized knowledge or skill are required for installation or commissioning, and all it takes is a screwdriver. Let's take a look at how the Eaton DE1 can get a motor online in no time, right out of the box. For the Eaton DE1 plug-in module, the first thing you'll need to do is select which pre-configured mode is best suited for your application. These 9 preset configuration options can be found on top of the plug-in module for quick reference in the field. For this example, we will set the plug-in module to mode 0. This will set our 4 inputs to provide a forward motor function on input 1, reverse motor function on input 2, fixed frequency on input 3, and in this case, input 4 is tied to this potentiometer, which allows us to manually influence the motor speed. Once the correct mode is selected for your required application, it's now time to set the rest of the parameters on the face of the plug-in module. We'll set the ramp speed time to 5 seconds. We'll set the fixed frequency to its max at 60 Hz. The mode is set at 0, and the motor current is set at 100% for this example. Now that you have all the basic parameters set on the module, you will simply plug the device into the DE1. The status light at the top right of the module will blink yellow, indicating that the new configuration needs to be uploaded. Simply press and hold the set button in the bottom right of the plug-in module and the drive will upload the new commands and hold a solid green light once the drive has successfully uploaded. A solid green light, and now we're uploaded to the drive. So now that we're all set, let's see how it works. Our input 1, as I said, is a forward motor function. Input 2 is now operating as our reverse command for our motor. Input 3 is operating at our fixed frequency, which we set on the front of our plug-in module at 60 Hz. And input 4 is now operating this potentiometer, which you can mount on your front of your control panel. We can ramp up the speed or ramp down as needed. From there, programming the rest of your drives is easy. Simply unplug the module, plug it into the next drive down the line, hit the set button, and you're ready to go. It is DIN rail mountable as well as screw mountable. It will allow for side-by-side installation with contact style wiring and available commoning links for busing multiple units together with a single line feed. The DE1 will communicate via RS-485 Modbus as standard, and Ethernet IP is an available option. So if you're looking for a simple solution for advanced starter applications with multi-speed capabilities, the Eaton DE1 is perfect for you. If you like this video, be sure to subscribe to Airline's YouTube channel. And please visit Airline's website where you can find the DE1 and other products available for easy ordering and fast delivery.